In the second part of task 10, we're going to sort the list. This is how to learn Scratch programming language. The Scratch program language is free, fun, and easy to learn. Most program languages are text-based, so a learner has to gain experience writing the code. But Scratch program is easier as it uses blocks. The learner selects blocks, puts them together, and runs the program in a simple way, making it the most fun and easiest way to learn programming. So we've got the code from finding the minimum, and we're just going to create the sorting algorithm, the selection sort, to put the nums in order. So we're just going to start off by removing the variables so we can see the wizard better, and there's quite a lot of code in the wizard. So we're just going to move that code over to the sprite so we've got more room inside the wizard to do our sort. So we're going to start off by creating the sort button. We can make it quicker by duplicating the button we've already got. Let's have a look in our costume, and when we've got find minimum, we can write sort. So let's move that button to where we would like it. And if we go back to our code, let's get rid of this code. And now when sprite is clicked, we want to broadcast sort. Okay. So now our sort button, once it's clicked, will broadcast sort. And now we want the wizard to sort the numbers. So let's use the broadcast. So we've got when I receive, and we want the sort. He's going to say let's pass one. So maybe for 1 second, and we're going to say pass. We can use join. And then we're going to have the number of the pass. So let's create a pass variable. Let's go to variables and make a variable, call that pass. Okay. And now we can add that pass to join. So you want to set the pass to equal 1. So when we're going through the sorting algorithm, the pass would be where we start. So we can loop through our list, but we're not going to check the last element, because if the first four elements are in order, we don't need to check the last one. So we need to repeat, and we can repeat that the length of the list minus 1. So we can go to our variables and find the length of the list. And we want that minus 1, so we use the operator, minus 1. So that's, we're going to repeat to the length of the list. Now, what we need here, we need to check to see if the number needs to be swapped over. Now, if it's not, then we don't need to swap it over. So we can use an if else. So we've got, let's put the say inside, so we're going to set the pass to 1, and then we're going to repeat through the loop. We're going to say which pass it is. We're going to check to see if our number is lower than the minimum index number, and if it's not, we don't swap, and if it is, we do swap. So we can check to see if the minimum index is greater than pass. So we go to our variables, and minimum index is greater than pass, then we're going to swap. So we can say swapping for 1 second, and maybe even if it's not moving, we can say in place no swapping. So if we don't need to change the number, then we don't need to swap any numbers. So now we need to look at creating our algorithm where we're going to move the lowest number to the position we want it in. So what we need to do here, we need to create another variable called temp. So let's create a variable temp. Okay, now we need to set the temp to equal the first number in the list. So the first number in the list, we can look for item one of list. So now we need to find the item that's in the minimum index and change that to the item of the pass. So now we need to replace the item in position one with the minimum index, item in the minimum index. So we've got the item and we want the minimum index. So the lowest number is say position 5, then we move that to position 1, which is our lowest place. So now we need to get the value, what we stored in temp, and put that in the item minimum index. We can do replace, and we've got item minimum index, and then we can go back to our temp variable, and that's our algorithm to swap over the numbers. So now we've got the algorithm to work when we've got the first number. So we can check, we've got numbers 100, 57, 10, 32, 71. We can find a minimum is 10. So the arrow moves to 10, and now if we sort, it should move the 10 to the first place, but then it's not going to move the rest, it's just the first element. So we need multiple passes. We need to broadcast minimum when we're repeating through the list. So we can go to our events and broadcast find minimum. So now when we go through the list multiple times, we don't start at 1. We're going to use pass. So we can add our pass variable into our code. So we replace the pass item rather than the first item. So we do that in our sorting algorithm, and when we find minimum, we set minimum index to pass rather than 1. So let's go back to our sorting code and check that. And we can finish off with changing the pass by 1. So we go through our list, and then at the end we need to put that inside the loop. So that's inside the repeat loop, and then at the end we can say that we're done. Okay, time to check our code. We can see here we've got replace item grade list of grade list with minimum. So there's a slight mistake there. So we need to take that out. So let's take that out. And it's minimum index. So now let's try that. We also need to make sure we set pass to 1 when we find minimum. So we can go to our variables and set pass to 1. So when we find our minimum, that we start off at the beginning. So let's try that. So it's not quite working, so we need to debug it. So what we've done, we've changed the broadcast to broadcast and wait. We've put place, we've spelt that correctly. But the issue here is that we've got the repeat, the length of grade list, minus 1. But actually we need to change that to minus pass. So let's run our program and see how we get on. We've got 94, 83, 99, 37 and 3. We can find the minimum, which is 3. Now we swap, Let's sort pass 1, so we want to swap 3 into the first place. Now we want to find 37 and swap that to the second place, and 83 swap that to the third place, and 94 we swap to the fourth place. So that's our algorithm. So let's put our numbers in order, and that's worked. So here's the final code for the find minimum, and the wizard we had, this is the final code for the sorting algorithm. Well, we hope you enjoyed that. Now, if you're interested in learning more or learning other programming languages, then please subscribe. And every time a video comes out, if you hit that notification bell, then that will let you know.